ladies and gentlemen. This is Eddie Marcus. I want to talk to you on a special subject this evening. You see this? What is this? No. This, ladies and gentlemen, is God. Yes, these are small denominations right here, but they get big and bigger, and they all come together to make up God. Now with this God, if you got enough of it, if you got enough of this God, you're talking about faith, if you got enough of this God, you can basically make your dreams come true. You can have the kind of house you want to live in, equipped like you want it, all the sports cars, nice things that you like. You could have it. You could travel anywhere you want, whenever you want. You got enough of this. You can have girls if you're a man, a man if you're a woman. You can have all of that if you got enough of this. You can travel the world. You can even get into politics. You can start in movies, bank movies, own theater houses, own towers. If you got enough of this, God. Now, many of you think that this is a simple matter. Whether you know it or not, every last one of you are caught up in this God. And you love this God. You love this God, and you will not give this God up. People can talk to you about Buddha. They can talk to you about Jesus Christ, Confucius, Allah, anybody they want to talk to you about. And you'll find people going along with conversations. You'll find people even blowing themselves up. But the bottom line is, in this life here, this is God. Now, some of you say you're thinking that you would give this God up if you knew what it would be. Let me tell you something. With this God, many of you own property. Some of you own buildings, houses, land, machinery. You own all kinds of things. You invested in that. All your life has been about this. Some of you just got a little bit, maybe a job, something as simple as a job. That might be all you can credit yourself with having, as far as assets are concerned. And you hold on to it with your whole life blood. If someone came to you and told you that you can have your dreams come true, you don't need any of this. The only people that would possibly listen are those people who got nothing. People who live under bridges, who sleep in the cold, they'd probably listen, hoping. They say, keep hope alive. They'll keep hope alive because they will be hoping. But if you got a little bit, well, you know, if you got $100, $250, you might sacrifice that. But if you got $1,000, plant a seed, talking about peace, prosperity for everybody on earth, where you can have not just what I just mentioned about this one guy. All of you can have your dreams come true like that. You would think that you'd jump on it. You think you'd be so glad. You start thanking God. Even if you don't believe in God, you'll start thanking God. But your faith is so far away from God, truthfully, and so into this God right here, that none of you would support God's plan for you to have peace and prosperity and joy. None of you would support it. And you go to church every Sunday, and you find some reason to sit there and listen to somebody talk about something. You get interested in it. Sometimes they mess with your emotions. Sometimes they tell you stuff. It's all wrapped up into the way the world is today. Everything that you hear is wrapped up in the way the world is today. Nothing is spiritual. The information that you get is not spiritual. It's about telling you what your purpose in life would be and is if you are born again. If the spirit of the living power is inside of you. Nobody's telling you what your purpose would be, your new purpose. How your purpose is to keep things beautiful. Show the way. We're in a world of darkness. Show the way. People don't know. To them, this truly is God. But to you, there's a God that says you don't have to lie, you don't have to cheat, you don't have to steal, you don't have to rob, you don't have to terrorize, you don't have to kill, you don't have to go to war. You don't have to do anything but just be a loving person. A person loving enough to want the best for yourselves and do anything you possibly could to help others to enjoy that same best for themselves. And in so doing, you would replenish the reservoir of goods and service that you, the people, have determined are so essential in your lives. And it, with your imagination, it will expand beyond your greatest imagination. And you will do monumental things, for you are an instrument of life, of creation. And we have learned now to put away this I'm better than you, or you're better than me. My country's better than yours. My country's the number one country. Your country isn't. All that stuff is baloney. All people are number one. All countries are number one. People are number one because they love. Countries are number one because they love their people, and the people express love unto one another, and they have the benefit thereof. And it's all a presentation of an understanding of a new birth, the renewing of our minds. Now, we're going to have a president pretty soon. We don't know who the candidates are going to be. But either way, it'll be Republican or Democrat. And they're going to be talking about this and talking about their terrorism going to be on the rise. And they're going to be prophesizing about this and that. And you, the people, are going to be caught all up in the PR when none of this is necessary. Let the government go on. But you, the people, it is time you wake up. It is time you wake up to start doing something. What you've got to start doing if you wake up, waking up means recognizing what's going on. And one beautiful thing about waking up, you can choose now if you're going to stay on that same old path or get on a different path that's taking you in the opposite direction. If you want to and you've got the will that you want to start something, a movement or whatever, then do it. If you want to join with somebody to help somebody do something for each other, then do that. But do something with the understanding that we want peace in America. We want prosperity in America. And we want joy in America for every citizen of this country. And we want to teach this to the Mexicans so they can stay at home. We want to teach this to everybody else who's coming from wherever you're coming from because of the reasons we all know so well. You don't have to do it. Because we will be the example. And whatever joy and beauty we have, you can have it immediately too. So I say these things to you, ladies and gentlemen. And I would try to say or repeat to you, I've said it 1,000 times about how this God's plan work. I just won't say it here because I don't have the time. But it's simple. It's simple as 1, 2, 3. But yes, that stuff that you're hanging on to, that car, that building, those houses, that land, that bank account, those stocks, those bonds, those businesses, those deals, you denying yourself true peace. And that's okay if that's what you want to do. But it hurts more than just you. It hurts the generation that comes after you, because they would not have experienced any growth. They would have gone deeper into the abyss, because the kind of living that is perpetrated at the expense of others like this, there's no place for it in the life of life. And so I say to you in closing, going to church, singing songs, praying for the sick, giving to the food shelves, are little things that Caesar has permitted you to do. He has permitted you to do it because it makes you feel like you are doing something. And it doesn't wear away at any of Caesar's business. As a being filled with the new spirit, your business is to enlighten. Now they talk about Satan enlightening. It is time you enlighten Satan and all of Satan's followers that there is a different way. And it's better than the way that they're on, because it benefits everybody. It doesn't require killing half the population and turn them into slaves. Doesn't involve any of that. It treats people as people want to be treated. Thank you so very much.